Hi, welcome to the show. I'm your host, Eric Jones. And today we are here in Brooklyn, right off of Broadway at Dewworth Street. And I'm finding that this is a real popular area here for artists. I'm going to be one of the artists who's not here from this country. We're going to talk about some of his work that he has actually painted all over Brooklyn. So I want you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Hi, how are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
And what's your name?
My name is Ilko.
Ilko, okay.
Yeah, it's a Dutch name. I'm from Holland.
Holland, I need to go to Holland, eh?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I need to go there.
Oh, yeah, well, we switch. I'd rather live here, and you go, you live in my house, I live at your house.
It's nice and cozy, eh?
Oh, it is, yeah. Okay. Yeah, it's small. It's a small country.
So, actually, tell me what inspired you as an artist, you know, because I see a lot of your work is just unbelievable. So what inspired you?
Well, actually, graffiti back in the days, as a kid, I was already painting, drawing a lot. You know, I had a hard time on school, no concentration, so I was always drawing. But I had a rough time. You know, I was always living on the streets because I couldn't get into the house. My mother is unfortunately a hoarder, so she stuffed the whole house. So I was like a young kid skateboarding. You know, raised up in a small village, graffiti sort of appeared in, you know, at a later stage. Uh-huh. But I found the books, like the Bibles, and I was like, this is it, you know. Oh. I'm a rebel, but I want to be anonymous. So I started stealing cans and started spray painting on the streets. And I think sort of my style sort of developed by just doing graffiti. Okay. Especially when I went to art school later on, I had a lot of problems with my teachers because there was no art, street art or any, you know, it was unknown. Mm-hmm. And they had a, you know, problem with me doing outlines and you know, my style that is sort of from the streets, that they couldn't understand what I was doing, but I just kept on doing it.
So what is the response when people see the actual work? What do they say?
I think they love it, especially when I stop doing letters, because I'm an illustrator. I work as an illustrator. I do a lot of corporate stuff, a lot of commission stuff. And last year I just decided to skip the letters and do more. Well, not, you know, no figures, because with illustration you draw a lot of people, and I was like, I want to go back as a kid drawing animals. I always like animals and human behavior, because eventually we are all animals.
Exactly.
So I started painting that, and the response is overwhelming. Mm-hmm. Especially when I decided to go back to New York. I was 2 years ago when I was fed up with working for clients. Oh. I just started, I was like, everybody told me, oh, don't go to New York, it's difficult, you have to know people. So I just went to on my own for 2 weeks. I met the test crew from the Bronx, and they just embraced me, gave me spots to paint, and I felt, you know, I raised up with hip-hop graffiti, and for the first time I really felt like, oh wow, this is it. This is what it should be, and what I was not feeling in Holland.
And you want me to move to Holland?
Oh yeah. So I can live the real, no, I'm Joe. I mean, yeah.
I don't think my Canadian family would want me to be there.
Oh yeah, okay. Well, I think it's, I mean, all the inspiration I have, you know, when it comes to movies, sort of art, skateboarding, mm-hmm. I feel that I'm really related to America, to the States. Okay. I was in California last year and I showed some of my works, and everybody sort of felt like, oh wow, you can see that you have been raised up with pictures and images, mm-hmm. from the States. So my inspiration is like, it goes back from the 60s, like psychedelic rock art, like the early posters and flyers, skateboard graphics, mm-hmm. Graffiti, of course.
I guess I really can't put a description on your art. Let's talk about the actual work here.
Yeah.
I'm the chair.
Okay. Well, this is a sort of commissioned wall. It's not for the money, it's more for making the streets look better. But because it's a bar and it's called the Lone Wolf, I'm gonna do something with the theme Lone Wolf. And we're working with a color scheme we're doing together with two other artists.